Hello, YouTubers, and welcome back to my kitchen. I'm so happy today as I will show you one of my favorite traditional delicacies. Greek rustic chicken pie. Golden crispy phyllo enclosing a juicy filling with veggies and chicken that will leave everyone speechless. A simple but elevated recipe that you have to try. And let's begin. To make the best chicken pie, rustic and Greek, we need a big pan, non-stick, on heat. I love this recipe. The most classic recipes in Greece are all the pie. So we're making pie almost with everything, with spinach, with veggies, with chicken, with meat, sweet pies, with custard. So actually, if you want to cook Greek, you have to learn how to make pies. And of course, instead of puff pastry, in Greece, we're using phyllo. Everybody knows phyllo. And the best quality phyllo, of course, is Greek. So, to make the best chicken pie ever, we just need some simple veggies and, of course, chicken. First, we will start with the veggies. I have one onion. And just roughly chop it. You don't have to make it perfect. It's a filling for a pie, so nobody sees the cuts of the veggies. So I will cut my onion here. And of course, everything starts with... not any olive oil, my friend. And extra Greek. This is very Greeky. It's 100% Greek olive oil. It's very important to be Greek, because if the olive oil is not Greek, the pie will not succeed. Okay? So, first ingredient goes in, onion. Mr. Onion is in. And then we will carry on with some peppers. I have some lovely different colored peppers here. I have red one, green one, and yellow one. What do you want, Lakis? He's a pepper hater. I don't know. So you don't like red hot chili peppers?
I like the...
the band.
Yeah, the band.
Yeah, but you don't like the peppers?
Yeah.
Yes, but you are not allergic. You just hate them.
I'm allergic.
You are not allergic. You just hate them. I know you, okay? Because sometimes when he's trying my recipes and I'm not mentioned that there are peppers inside and he's eating the food, he's like, okay, you have peppers inside. And I'm, yes, I have all peppers inside. And he's just, okay, I'm not eating. He's not allergic, okay? And I know that. So if you meet Lakis anytime in your life and he tells you that he is allergic in peppers, don't believe him. He's a liar. He just don't like peppers. So probably this the same happens to every people, right? Did you have any ingredients that you didn't like when you were a kid? Which one? Eggplant. Eggplant is the best veggie. It's the queen of all veggies, you know that, huh? Eggplant is my favorite veggie. And you like it, except peppers? He doesn't like ginger also, right? And coriander?
Yeah, I like it.
So I hope in your next life, Lakis, not to become an Asian, because you will have a serious problem with doesn't like ginger and, of course, coriander. So I need to make a recap. I have here peppers, onion, olive oil, and, of course, some garlic. One clove of garlic if it's big, two if they are small. Now, thinly slice them. And garlic goes in. We want the flavor of the garlic. I don't care if there are big chunks, because actually they will melt inside the filling. And now it's time for caramelization. We need some sugar and we need some dry oregano, one of our favorite herb in Greece. Now, I will saute my veggies. And let's spicy up this filling with some coriander seeds. You like coriander like this?
Yeah.
So I will put them whole like it is. Have this lovely bite when I'm eating my pie, and I want to make it a little bit spicy, so I have chili flakes here. This should be enough, and now I have a nice, tasty, sexy, and very, very tasty veggie mix here. Of course, I have to add a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper, and life is good. I love these recipes, because actually you can use any veggies you have in your house. You can use any leftovers to make a pie, and that's the whole philosophy of the pies in Greece. In ancient Greek, the pies were so traditional because other people had flour, had water, and had some herbs outside of the house. So they were picking the herbs and they're just making a pita, a pie, with all these herbs. And that's why we love pitas. Pies are the food of the poor, we say in Greece. So everybody can afford to make a pie because actually you don't have to buy ingredients to make a pie. You're just picking things that you already have in your fridge. Now, I have my chicken here and I have leftover chicken, and you can use any other meat you have leftover in your fridge. I have some breast, some thighs. Thighs? It's very hard word for me, the thighs. Thighs, okay? So we have chicken breast and thighs, and I will chop my chicken breast and my thighs. And while I'm caramelizing my veggies, I will add my chicken. You don't have to do it in two different pans. If your chicken is raw, you have to cook it in a different pan, but this is completely cooked, nice, tender, and sexy, so I don't want to overcook it. I will just add the chicken inside the veggies. This recipe needs about 15 minutes to be ready to go inside the oven. So probably you will need 15 minutes also, because I know that everybody that watching those videos from my channel, they are cooking experts. So please feel free to be creative, add something more, take something out of the recipe. Not the meat, because you will not make chicken pie after. But you can add more veggies, take out peppers, add some eggplants, some zucchinis, more onion, some parsley, what else? Some leek, amazing, leek will give this sweetness that we want in the recipe. And this is absolutely stunning, look at that. The only thing you have to remember when you are making a pita, a pie, Greek way, and you're using phyllo, we don't want the filling to be runny. We don't want to have a lot of liquid inside, because actually we'll make soggy the phyllos. And the phyllos we want to be crunchy and sexy and golden brown. So the only thing you have to remember, add anything you want in the filling, but make sure that the filling will be quite dry, okay? You got it? Now, it's time to put everything together in this lovely filling. So I will deglaze my pan with a little bit of wine just to take all this lovely flavor from the pan and put it inside again to the filling. And of course, everything will have a nice body with what my friend like is. Tomato paste. Tomato paste giving a nice body and texture to my filling. Now I have to take a spatula and mix everything together. In a few minutes, you will taste the most delicate chicken pie ever. And my filling is almost ready. We want just to make sure that it's not runny, quite dry, and we will give this lovely softness with what? I will take off the heat and I will add something very important for this recipe. What it is like is... and Gruyere cheese. We need cheese. If you add cheese, you will have more body. Okay, so now, please add the cheese, Gruyere cheese, and of course, feta cheese. If you want, you can add Italian feta cheese. I'm just kidding, there is no Italian feta cheese. I just wanted to see if you know that feta cheese is totally Greek. My cheese is here, my filling is ready. And do you want to add any more herbs to the filling? You like thymari? Thymari is thyme. You can add any herbs you like. You can add rosemary, you can use oregano, you can use any herbs you have in your house. So my filling is ready. It's time to mix everything. Woohoo! Sexiness. Nobody can handle this sexy filling. Actually, this filling is ready to be served with some spaghetti. Why not? With some potato mass. Why not? But we will use this filling to make the most extraordinary pie. We'll make a Greek pie, so I need my phyllo. I'm going to the fridge. And this is my phyllo, okay? So, probably if you're living outside of Greece, you will not find this size of phyllo nowhere. This is the most common size of phyllo we have in Greece. but I don't know why. Outside of Greece, England, UK, the phyllos are small. So in total, we need about 450 grams of phyllo. So if the packets have 250, take two packages to make sure that the phyllo should be enough to cover the pie. Now, I will open my packets. And at this point, when you're opening a package of phyllo, you have to be very, very fast. The phyllo is getting dry very easily. So be gentle, open it. You don't care if it breaks. We don't care at all. Because actually, we're making a very rustic pie. So we don't care even if the phyllo breaks in some parts. At this point, you have to be very confident. Have everything ready, the filling, the phyllos, some olive oil. And since you opened the package of the phyllo, you have to prepare it in less than 5 minutes. Can you like this? Okay, you have to do that very, very fast. So I need one phyllo here. As you can see, my phyllo breaks, but we care? No, we don't care. Don't care, please. Because if the phyllo doesn't break, means that the phyllo is very thick. So it will not become crispy and it will not become sexy. Olive oil, phyllo, phyllo, more phyllo. Olive oil, and again, more phyllo. We need about 5 to 6 seeds on the bottom and 5 to 6 seeds on top. So I have 4 till now. I will put one more, and then it's time for the filling. And this is the last one from the bottom side. Woohoo! And I am at 1.5 minutes. Probably I will finish it in 2.5 minutes because I am amazing and because I know exactly what I'm doing. And if you have time to leave the filling to get the rest for a while and not to be so hot, it's good to do that. But if you don't have time, it's okay again because we love you and irrelevant, but it's okay. And olive oil. And we need 4 to 5 phyllos on top also. So I will fold the edges this way. And I need some more phyllos on top to make sure that this pie would be the best pie ever. Should I put one more? But before I put my phyllo, what I have to do, my friend, like this? Of course. Always olive oil, always olive oil. And just remember, it's very easy to prepare your own pie. Give the shape you want, put it in any tray you have at home, just make it rustic and feel very, very nice. Now, I have my brush here, and for the last greasing with olive oil, I will use it to put the edges inside this way. I'm quite fast. Not good for a man, though, but it's okay, you know, in making pies. And now, more olive oil on top, and it's time to score the pie. And I'm telling you score because we don't want the knife to go through the pie. We're just giving a nice shape. And after, when it's ready, we'll cut the pie, okay? Now, I will score it nice and beautiful like this. And it's time for the oven. My oven is preheated to 170 degrees Celsius at the fan, and guess what? We will cook this lovely pie for approximately 1 hour. It's very important the rack of the oven to be as high as possible because we want the air from the oven to go under in the tray and make the pie crispy on the bottom side. Because if you put it in lower level, then the pita will be crispy on the top side, but at the bottom side, will be soggy. We want that like this? Nobody likes soggy pies like this, okay? Everybody wants crispy, nice, sexy pies, and this is the pie we are making at KitchenLab. So, my pie is ready, and I want you to put the volume at the highest level and listen to this crunch sound. That's why, my friends, Greek pies are the best all over the world because Greek pies has this lovely crunch filling, the essence of the crunchiness and at the same time the yumminess of the filling and the juiciness. Oh my God, it's so complete, because always in our food we're searching for something crunchy and something tasty, and this pie has everything because it's totally balanced and very, very easy to make. Do you want to see what's happening from the inside of the pie? Okay. Look at this. Yumminess. Oh my God. Oh my God. What do you think? Crunchiness and yumminess at the same recipe. It's possible? Of course it is. So it's time to taste. Are you ready? I already promised Michalis for a piece of this yumminess. I want to show you how crunchy it's from the bottom side. Can you see that? My friend Michalis, it's because we put the pie at the highest level inside the oven. This is for you, my friend. And this is for you. Έλα να σου δώσω την πίτα σου. This is for you. Και αυτό είναι για τη Βάγια. And this is for me. Subscribe, make comments under the video, and please try this lovely recipe. Share with people. Cook this recipe. What else, Lakis? Oh my God. The taste. It's so unique. The feta cheese complete this heaviness. It's so rich, it's so phyllo, it's so crunchy, it's so amazing, it's so Greek, it's so something you have to try.